Excuse my face today. I just got back from the barn trying to beat this crazy heat wave that we've been having here in California. It is ridiculous. Literally, I got to the barn before 8 a.m. and it was already 96 degrees outside. For us Californians, it's pretty hot. Last I checked, when I got back to the house, it was already 112 degrees outside. To my channel. My name is Brett Rossi, and if you have accidentally stumbled upon my channel, do me a huge favor, hit that subscribe button because I have new vlogs that come out every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You don't want to miss out because we talk about all the things you may need to know and maybe all the things you don't need to know. Today I wanted to talk about something that a lot of you are very curious to know. A lot of my followers on my social media inquire about my studies. Something that you may or may not know about me is that I love to study, I love to learn, I love to read. I'm kind of nerdy in that aspect. Last semester was pretty awesome. I studied statistics and it was a very hard class for me because I am definitely not a math whiz. I am more of a science whiz. Math is pretty challenging to me overall, but I got an A in my statistics class and that was pretty cool because, quite frankly, I did not expect it at all. I really struggled through the whole course, and then coronavirus hit. We switched from in-person learning to distance learning, and that was difficult to adjust in itself. I've taken online classes before, but certain classes I really prefer to take in person just because it's easier to grasp the concept of whatever it is you're studying. And then certain classes I can definitely do distance learning online and not have a problem with it. The one question I get all the time from my followers is, how are my studies going and how is school going? Last year, I started working on an ambulance and I got a taste of the medical field. And then I realized that this job really wasn't for me. There are so many different reasons that I could list why I realized the medical field wasn't for me, but the number one reason was that I was constantly looking over my shoulder in hopes that people wouldn't find out or discover my past career in adult entertainment. It became exhausting constantly looking over your shoulder, and the reason why I had this constant anxiety was because of the fact that I was bullied out of my LVN school when they found out that I was in adult entertainment. When I started my new career working on an ambulance, I really did not want people to find out because I didn't want to have to relive that whole thing all over again. I went to such great extremes that I legally changed my name and I totally deleted my social media and I distanced myself from everything that was like a public figure. And I did that for about 6 months and I got really exhausted and I started to lose touch with who I am as a person, and that was really hard. I am such a happy-go-lucky person, and I know that the job itself, the pressures of being responsible for saving someone's life, was hard enough. Add in the pressures of hiding a past of yours that you know people will judge you and that you could possibly lose your job over, which I don't think is fair, but that's a whole other tangent. Right when the coronavirus pandemic hit, I was like, I'm out, I'm done working on an ambulance, I can't do this anymore, I need to be true to myself. During the pandemic, I really took the time to reflect and figure out what it is I truly want to do with my life, because, I mean, looks don't last forever, and the entertainment world in itself is very up and down, but I wanted to do something where I could still be in entertainment, but also have another side hustle, have another career that could sustain my lifestyle. And that's when I decided to change my major. I decided to change my major from nursing back to business, And then I decided to go to beauty school. Now I know what you guys are thinking. You're like, oh God, every girl who doesn't want to go to college goes to beauty school. Well, first off, beauty school is pretty tough. You have to do like 16 months of hardcore schooling. I decided that I would go to beauty school because I love hair, I love makeup, I love making other women feel beautiful, and I was like, you know what? Why don't I make a living doing this? I already do it for fun. I already do makeup and hair for fun. Why don't I do it for a living? So I decided that I would change my major to business so I can properly run a business, even though the last 10 years I've technically been running my own business, my business of my brand, but I really think it's important that I get my degree in business so I can learn all the nitty-gritty aspects of running my own salon. What I'm going to do is I am going to get my degree in business and I am going to go to beauty school, and once I get my beauty license, I'm going to open up my own salon. I want the salon to be a place where women can go to feel safe, confident, beautiful, and I just overall want to make people's days better. I want to make women feel beautiful. And what's really cool is by choosing this career path, I don't have to hide who I am. I don't have to hide my past. I already know so many people, so getting my business up and going won't be as challenging as, say, the normal person would be, because I already have so many connections and I already know so many different people that are in need for hair services and makeup services. By doing so, I really am looking forward to opening my own salon and doing hair and makeup and not being judged for my past and not be worried that I'm gonna get fired because somebody found out that, oh my gosh, I do adult. And what's also really cool is I can do hair and makeup simultaneously while still feature dancing or doing whatever it is I want to do in the entertainment aspect. I don't have to choose just one. And that was a struggle that I dealt with on the regular. I've been in the entertainment industry since I was a kid, even way before adult. I have been modeling since I was a kid. So making that decision to leave the entertainment business as a whole has been really difficult on me, because I still want to do music videos here and there. I still want to do appearances and all of the fun things that come with the freedom of being in entertainment. But then I struggled with the fact that I wanted to be in entertainment, but it's so unstable. I really wanted a stable fallback career, something that, okay, this is like my main source of income and this is like my fun income. With that being said, that is why I decided to change my major. A lot of the reason was because I needed to find something that was more suited for me. I am a very sensitive person, and working in the medical field really, really affected me emotionally, and I just couldn't handle it. I love helping people so much, but there's just way too much nitty-gritty details I could go into, but I'm not going to, because I respect all healthcare workers. They work so hard. They're overworked and underpaid, and they're definitely underappreciated. I totally respect that line of work, but with my experience, I just came to realize that, you know what, it's not something I want to do with my life, and I'm so glad that I figured it out now versus getting my nursing license, start working as a nurse, going through all this stuff, and then I'm like stuck in a career that I absolutely dread and hate. This is my story. It was a quick little vlog just to give you guys an update, because a lot of you guys have been super curious about my schooling, my education, what's going on, and now you know. I will see you guys next time. Thanks for tuning in. See you later.